All right, it's about time to make a start again. Please return to your seats.
All
right, members, let's resume our meeting. Just now, we adjourned the meeting because Mr. Andrew Leung produced extra documentation for members. I have on the list Ms. Yao Wai-ting and Mr. Jeffrey Lam. I'm not sure whether you would like to take the floor. Mr. Lam gives up your chance. Ms. Yao Wai-ting. All right then, Ms. Yao Wai-ching. Chairman, members were talking about two issues. The first one is the eligibility of the candidate and also the eligibility of the voters. There were members who talked about Mr. Andrew Leung's eligibility. I don't really want to belabor the point. I've read the document that just came through. Other than the UK citizenship, I think we have to find out whether Mr. Leung has in his possession other rights of a vote before we can ascertain his eligibility to run for president's office. Now, I wonder why we allow him to keep supplementing the information. He failed to produce all the relevant information, and we have to pull off the meeting. Either Mr. Leung withdraws his candidacy, or the secretariat rules that his candidacy is invalid, and then we can declare Mr. James To the president. The secretariat ruled very quickly that we were not properly sworn in, but why is it that the secretariat is not as swift in ruling Mr. Leung's eligibility?
Now, the crux of the matter is that Mr. SG has said that we have not completed the oath. He has not ruled that our oaths are invalid. We'll have to resolve this problem today. First, allow us to take the oath or affirmation again, and the secretariat should state that we have completed the process. As to whether the oath or affirmation is valid, it should be ruled upon by the president. So we will not flout ROP 12 bracket 2. If the three members have not completed the oath-taking process and yet you get on with the presidential election, then it will be questioned. Many members said, if you're not happy with this, go to the court. I must reiterate here, the executive, the judiciary, and the legislature are the three powers that are separated. The legislature has its own particular constitutional position. We represent the people. We should resolve conflicts here within the legislature. We should not take everything to the court. We should stop intervention by the executive. We should defend the independence of the legislature, and we should not allow the judiciary to intervene. Thank you. Any other members who would like to speak? Every member will be able to speak only once because of the limit of time. And I would ask you to be concise. If you are speaking for a second time, well, sorry, I'm not going to allow that. I would only allow members to speak once. Does any other member wish to speak? If not, I'm chairing the meeting today, and I make decisions. I have decided that if you have a point of order to make, you will be able to speak only once. How do you know I'm not going to deal with it? How do you know I'm not going to deal with it? If you understand, then please hold your tongue. Let me speak now. Thank you. Members, I need to make one point. I am a senior member. I have been a member for 21 years. However, I have never chaired any meetings. It was only yesterday and today that I had an am chairing a meeting. Yesterday, I thank you for your cooperation. So the meeting was, the special forum was conducted smoothly. I'm chairing this meeting. This is a formal Legislative Council meeting. And it is regulated by the rules of procedure. And it has its own procedures to follow as well. My understanding is that the purpose and process of this council meeting are very simple. As I said, first, members will be able to take an oath or affirmation to become members. And secondly, we will elect the president. And I will be responsible for arranging the voting process, and I will announce the results after voting is completed. I will declare a candidate who is elected president. So in the meeting, no members should raise questions or seek clarifications. And according to the ROP, the secretariat particularly arranged a forum for members to ask questions of the candidates. Of course, I understand that yesterday and today, many members have raised queries about the right of abode in foreign countries of Mr. Andrew Leung. And after knowing that, I tried to make available time and space for Mr. Andrew Leung to give an account to the media outside the chamber, and members could also have a better understanding of the issue. But after that, many members still have questions. That is why, if you had a point of order to make, I allowed you to speak. And so I gave you time to speak, and you were able to raise questions or seek clarifications. Now, we should start the voting process, but members asked many questions and they needed to be answered. And there are also legal issues. I myself also think they should be resolved, and yet they are not resolved completely as of now. Why is that so? It is because in this meeting, our legal advisor will not be making any clarifications, and our secretariat will not be explaining the entire process for members. This is not within the ROP, and therefore, we are not allowed to do it, and therefore, the legal advisor or the secretariat will have no opportunity to give clarifications or answer members' questions. And because of this, since I also have some questions within my mind that are not clarified, I will now announce to you that I will not chair the voting process. I will leave the chair. And according to the ROP, we will have another senior member who will be in the chair, and this will be Mr. Abraham Sheikh. And according to the ROP, I will not be able to stay in the chamber. I will need to recuse myself, and I will not take part in the voting process. I must apologize to members. I might not have done the best job as a chairman. I hope you will understand me and forgive me. Thank you. The three members elect have not completed their oath-taking process. Why is it that the legal advisor or the secretariat would not explain in public? I don't know why they are not speaking up. Is it that we have powers to please ask them to speak up? So we can have these questions resolved. And legal advisor and the secretariat, what is the status of the three members? Mr. Andrew Leung has given us the original document, and half of the questions have been resolved. You are not the chairman, I am, said Mr. Leung Kwok-hong. I will warn Mr. Leung Kwok-hong. You have exhibited improper behavior. If you still do not leave the seat of the chairman, I will ask you to leave the chamber. You may want to be difficult, but the council should have some dignity. Do not resort to using force. Mr. Leung Kwok-hong, I will give you one more chance. If you do not return to your seat, do you understand what is a green card? Mr. Leung, this is your last chance. I have given you warnings. I have been a member for 16 years. I have not seen this happen. We cannot allow force. You were trying to snatch the microphone from me. Well, okay. We are colleagues. Let us cooperate. We still have 4 years ahead of us. I'm giving Mr. Leung Kwok-hong the last chance. If you continue to disrupt the meeting and prevent members from exercising our duty, then, I'm asking you and other members to I always act with caution. I respect members. Is it a point of order? Well, first of all, I need to exercise my duty first. Should I be the chairman? Under 1A, Mr. James Toh, please read 1A. Mr. Leung Yiu-chung is not here. Of course, you are the most senior member. And then Leung Yiu-chung is next, and then I follow. Mr. Leung Yiu-chung, please allow me to do my duty here. Whether I have the power to expel people, but I have the authority to chair the meeting. If the meeting cannot go on, I think I have that power. It happens this way. Only panel chairmen have the power to expel members. I will. You don't have that power at all. Where do you derive your powers? Mr. James Toh, refer to the ROP. Let us adjourn the meeting for 10 minutes. When we come back, if Mr. Leung Kwok-hong still remains in the chair, we will have the meeting in another venue.